preserve your memories. They're all that's left you.
Tribute at the Theatre of Dreams to the man who made their dreams come true, George Best. You're joining us from Sky Sports One. Welcome to Gillette Soccer Saturday. In the studio, Frank McClintock, Matt Letizier, Paul Walsh and Charlie Nicholas. We'll hear from them shortly. But first, our own tribute to George, who worked with us for almost 10 years.
Georgie, Georgie, they call you the Belfast boy. Georgie, Georgie, they call you the Belfast boy. And they say, Georgie, Georgie, keep your feet on the ground. Georgie, Georgie, when you listen to the sound. Georgie, Georgie, put a light on your name. Play the game. Play the game.
I actually think I was the greatest player of all time. I didn't just play long enough at the top. But circumstances dictated that, you know, and I can't change it. And I was lucky. I had 11 great years, and it's 11 more than a lot of people get.
You would disagree with him. Even Pelé thought he was the best he'd ever seen.
If someone said it's impossible to beat four men, I would try and beat four men, because it was the dare that said you can't do it. And I don't actually believe that nothing's impossible, but there's very few things impossible, and I would have a go at anything.
Virtually anything was possible where George was concerned, and he always enjoyed the rewards that fame brought.
Get your motor running. Head out on the highway. Looking for adventure. In whatever comes our way.
It all started in Belfast. He was just 16 when Matt Busby came to his home and signed him up for Manchester United. Within 2 years, he helped United lift the title. Then he made his mark in Europe, scoring twice against the mighty Benfica. By now, he was as big as the Beatles. In 1968 came the defining moment in his career.
Oh, he's got a great chance! Oh, he must! He has!
United had beaten Benfica again, 4-1 this time.
George Best. Remember what happened in 1981 today, George?
I can't remember last night, yeah. When they first started talking about video evidence, they all said it'll never work. You know, the fans won't stand for it. They said the fans wouldn't stand for all-seater stadiums. And you can...
On a serious note, I mean...
I'd spot my wife for Bobby Robson.
On a serious note, George, I mean...
It was a great lineup of action to come here on the Premiership tonight. But sadly, we must start tonight's show by paying tribute to a football genius. Great memories of a man who this afternoon was remembered around the grounds he once used to grace.
Request that all true football supporters now join us in a period of silence to respect a true footballing legend, George Best.
Well, Liverpool
And Man City disgraced themselves in comparison to the others, didn't
they?
Did it surprise you?
Very. Yeah, I was very surprised with what happened today. I mean, the referee had to cut it short to about 25 seconds. There was just too much noise, and I think he did the right thing. But surprisingly, from the point of view that everything that Liverpool's been through as a club, Heysel, Hillsborough, and the respect they received from other clubs during them traumatic times, surely the fans today could have waited 1 minute to pay respect to one of the greatest players ever.
Feel a bit ashamed, did it?
I think should do. I'm sure they'll be watching other stations this evening, whatever, watching the football, seeing what happened, and they'll be extremely disappointed with how they acted today. But unfortunately, Bill, you're always going to have mindless idiots at football matches who act that way.
Yeah. Now, John, Michael Parkinson was a friend of George Best for 40 years. Mm. And writing over the last couple of days, he said it was difficult to explain to people who didn't see him play how different George Best was. What was the difference?
Oh, I think the balance and skill of Georgie Best, particularly. I think balance, George. I've never seen anybody as well balanced as Georgie Best. Most players can go off the left side or off the right side. He can go off both sides. And he would seem to be falling over sometimes, Bill. And he'd be up and he'd be gone. And very, very, extremely quick, brave, and good on both sides. So he could do a lot most players can't do. He could go past people. And players that can go past people are always extremely dangerous because they can do it on their own. Mm. They're not waiting for other people for passing movements and that. They can get on the ball, go past two or three people, and if you can do that, you get teams in all sorts of trouble. And George is brilliant at that.
Yeah, you played with him, of course, in Man U. But in assessing his career, you said he was better than Pelé and above Cruyff, but Maradona came close to him.
I don't remember saying that, Bill, actually. I think Pelé was regarded as the best player in the world, but I'd say Georgie Best was up there with any of the top players, whether it be Maradona, Pelé, Bobby Charlton, who very seldom gets a mention, by the way, Cruyff, all those great players. Georgie was up there, and Cruyff was a great dribbler of the ball, but there was none better than Georgie. But Georgie was up there. But all these great players you'll find, Bill, they're all unique. You never get two of anybody. Mm. I mean, Georgie Best wasn't like Pelé in his play, but it's all about effectiveness. How they affect the results, how they affect the game. And Pelé could do it in a certain way, and Georgie could do it in a different way.
Mm. Did you see him play?
I played alongside him, Bill, at the later end of his career, in his 30s. There was a testimonial match in Oxford at the time, and George was there. Very quiet man. Well, a lot of people wouldn't believe that, but when he came in the changing room, he just sat down, got changed, didn't say too much. But there was an aura about him when he walked into the changing room. Everyone who was in there sort of turned and looked at him because of what he's achieved in his footballing career. The talent that he was, I mean, as John quite rightly says, you don't get two players the same. I don't think there'll ever be another Georgie Best, to be brutally honest with you. He had everything at a young age. He won major trophies with Manchester United at the age of 22, you know, European Cup winner, scored in the final as well. And it's just unfortunate that people might see the other side of him or look at the other side of him. I hope they remember the tribute that was shown earlier on in the show, which was the great goals that he scored and the way that he could beat players so easily.
Danny Blanchflower, writing about him quite a few years ago, said that he had greater appeal to the senses, is the way he put it, than either Matthews or Finney, and he offers a greater surprise to the eye and the mind because he could do so much.
Well, I think he did it in different parts of the pitch. I think in the old days you had the right wingers, whether it be Finney and Matthews, they played on the right wing, Bill, and they stayed on the right wing. And Georgie Best could move all over the pitch and do it from both sides. Now, I wouldn't have seen Matthews at his best. I wouldn't have seen Finney at his best. But these guys were magicians as well. Mm. But I can see what Danny's saying. Georgie didn't actually, after the first year or so, Georgie didn't play on the wing at all. Georgie could go anywhere in the pitch and do his stuff, which he did, and did it brilliantly. Whereas in the generation before Georgie Best, Matthews and Finney would be restricted to that right-hand side. But apparently, Bill, I spoke to people who saw them at their peak, and they were magicians as well.
Mm. Now, I want to ask you something in relation to Bobby Charlton, because again, from my reading over the last few days, he made a curious comment, Charlton did. He said he admitted that he was hostile to Best, and he admitted that possibly that was a mistake, that Best did not get the support in Man United that perhaps he should have got, and he was treated very differently, say, to Cantona, who got special treatment. And his argument was, if Best had got special treatment because of who he was and his great skills, things might have developed differently.
Well, I think Cantona would have got special treatment and Ryan Giggs would have got special treatment because of the experience of George Best. George Best was the first superstar of his type at that particular stage of Manchester United. You're going back to 1963, Bill. Now, in those days, I went to Manchester as a 15-year-old, saw the Georgie Best a few years after me, and you're put into digs and you look after yourself. Now, when Georgie Best got into the first team, he was only 17, and by the time he was 18, he was a superstar. Now, superstars of today would be given advisors, protection, they'd be living in a hostel, all the various things that Alex Ferguson did for Ryan Giggs. Georgie Best had none of that. He was left to his own devices as a 17, 18-year-old. No wonder he went off the rails, and I think that's what Bobby would be alluding to when he would be saying that. Yeah. Now, Bobby wasn't in a position himself to protect Georgie Best in the way that he should have been protected. That was the club's responsibility.
But it was one of the things that came across, actually, in the course of a lot of this comment, was that the players were too busy looking after themselves to look after George.
No, George had never happened before, Bill. This was the swinging 60s. This was the fifth Beatle. Yeah. We had Matthews and Finney, who were great sportsmen before, but George had transcended that into the showbiz life. Yeah.
And which he was possibly a young, brought him down, is it?
Well, it was his downfall. He was a good-looking lad. As Georgie said himself, if he'd looked like, who was it, Peter Beardsley, he wouldn't have had the troubles that he had, because he was such a good-looking lad.
And the amount of women that started to come and watch football on the back of George Best playing, before that, I would say it was predominantly male-orientated, Bill, and they were saying there was tens of thousands of young girls.
A bit like yourself when you were playing.
Not at all, Bill.
We turned them away.
All right, OK, but...
Who stole a soul from the sun in a world come undone as it seems? Let there be let.
Pride.
Sentiment is Pat, and Pat knew him very, very well indeed. The two of them used to room together, and of course it was an absolute privilege to be in the Northern Ireland squad at that time, for you would go up and join, and just to be in that room with the two of them was pretty special indeed. For one, dare I say, it was I was just coming into the game at that stage when George was probably absolutely at his peak, and so I didn't play that often with him. But when I did, it was...